What's up, everybody? It's me, Craw. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, thanks for stopping by. If it's a return trip, thanks for coming back. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe so you don't miss future content. Leave me a comment below. Let me know you're getting value out of these videos. Today, we're going to talk about mechanical keyboard switches and all the parts inside. Let's get after it. Mechanical switches 101. We'll start with the ever popular cherry red. This one's actually Gateron red, but they're the same. Throw this guy on the opener. Here you go. So you can see the little legs. They're flat straight across. That's what makes it a linear. This is the stem. Those are the legs. The legs are what affects what style of switch it is. Then you have the spring, bottom housing, top housing. Some are clear. Some are opaque. Depends on how much LED you want. That's about the only difference. There's a few different materials. See if I can't kind of demonstrate this. So this rides on these leaves here that make the contact, and it, since it's a linear, it's just a straight shot. The pressure never changes, start to finish. That's a linear. Throw this guy back together, and we will go now to tactile. This would be a drop holy panda. These are pretty nice. One of my faves. Get this guy open. Same deal. Grab on this little stem. And as you can see on his little legs, there's a distinct curve. That's what causes the bump. It's what makes this a tactile. Try to demonstrate this a little bit. So there's the little bump, bump. Not the easiest thing to see, but you can definitely feel the difference. Throw his little lid back on. And now, the also popular, or annoying, depending on your choice, blue switch. It's a Gat blue. Don't know if you can hear the click, but it definitely has an audible click, and I'll show you why. Pull this guy apart. You can already see his little two-piece stem a little bit. Oh, spring's trying to escape. So there's his little floating clicker. And you can see, once you get enough pressure, that guy snaps through, and you get the click. These are one switch that you don't lube. These are all MX style switches, so they use the same switch puller. Something to just connect to those four little legs there. And then one switch I want to show you to demonstrate the difference. This is a Kailh box switch. It's a silent switch also, so we'll have a couple different things to talk about. But this is a Kailh box red or pink. I've heard it referred to as both. This is basically Kailh's version of a silent red. Takes a different switch opener. As you can see, it's got a long tab there that runs the length of the switch. These ones are a little more interesting to open. We got lucky today. So they got right there. So this has an itty bitty little leg right there. It's a linear switch, so it's just smooth. Smooth little leg. No long legs, you ask. Well, no visible leaf spring either. But you can see that little green nub. That's the actuator for this switch. This covered up part is where the leaf spring would be. It is inside the box, hence the Kailh box switch name. These are dust and moisture resistant, which you gotta love that. I mean, who doesn't want a little snack while you're gaming? Keep your keyboard nice. But this switch is still linear, but it just actuates that little nub. I don't know if you can see the little nub in there. And now, to tell you why this is a silent switch. Set that guy down. You can see on the bottom, the two little white pads. Those are little rubber bumpers. Oops. On the top, two little white pads for the rebound. Also rubber bumpers. So when you press this switch down, it hits the bumper. When it releases, it hits another bumper on its way back up. And that's what makes it quieter than your average switch. Get this guy back together. A little more challenging. Get on in there. Maybe I have it backwards, because you know that happens. There we go. He's all back together. And listen. Probably don't hear much. Clicky. Tactile. Lubed. A little thock gear. And a standard red. No lube. And just so you know how many switches are available, Kailh Box Red, Gateron Red Ink. These are all just variations of the tried and true red switch. So get this guy out of the way. All these are pretty much variations of one switch. Minor differences in the housing material, silent, standard, box, clicky, tactile, panda. And there it is, real basic. Pretty much four parts. Top housing, bottom housing, stem, spring. That's what's in a switch, that's what makes them go, and that's some of the differences in them. There you go, the ins and outs of mechanical switches, all the little moving parts covered. Hopefully you got some value out of this video. If you did, make sure you hit that like and subscribe. Leave me a comment below. Let me know what kind of switches you're using and what kind of mods you've done to them. Thanks for stopping by, and as always, stay chill.